We went for a cruise vacation recently. I took this time lapse on the cruise ship. The sunset was very beautiful, but the footage is very shaky and the horizon was bouncing a lot. Here is the zoomed in look of the bouncing horizon. This is after stabilization and deflickering. After some research and many trials and errors, I figured out how to stabilize the ocean horizon. Here's the zoomed in look of the horizon. It looks quite steady. This is the side-by-side comparison of the original footage on the left and stabilized and deflickered footage on the right. For this tutorial, you need to have two tools, Adobe After Effects for stabilization and TLDR for deflickering. For the best result, we are going to stabilize first and then deflicker. Start up After Effects. Import the edited JPEG files and make sure the composition has the same dimension as the original pictures for best quality. Check the Import JPEG sequence box. Create a duplicate layer of the original sequence by copying and pasting it in the timeline panel. Create a new shape layer from the layer menu. Make sure this new shape layer is on the top. We want to draw several thin vertical green rectangle pairs. These rectangles are very important in making sure the tracking points won't drift horizontally. Bright green color was chosen because this color doesn't exist on the ocean horizon. You can use different colors for your sequence as long as the color of the bars is contrasted to the horizon. In this video, we are going to start with two pairs of bars, which is the minimum required. Make sure the distance between two bars in the same pair is small. The bars should be put into positions where horizon is clearly visible, and there should be some distance between two pairs of bars for better result. Because time lapse can last hours, once visible horizon may be hard to see later or even blocked. In this case, you may want to switch tracking points to a different location. That is why having more than two pairs of bars may help. These are two pairs of bars we're going to use for stabilization. You should verify if the horizon is clearly visible and contrasty between the bars in the same pair during the whole time-lapse sequence. During the playback, I noticed that the remote islands on the right side appear to be very similar in color and brightness to the ocean. Motion trackers may have trouble tracking the horizon in that case. So I created another pair of bars slightly to the left where there is no island. Collapse all shape layers. Select all shape layers and one of the two original sequences right below the shape layer and right click. Find and click Pre-compose in the context menu. Check Move All Attributes into the new composition. There are only two layers left in the timeline. Select the newly created pre-composition layer and find Tracker panel. Select Stabilize Motion and check both position and rotation. Move the tracker 1 to the horizon in between two bars on the left and move tracker 2 to the right. The position of the tracker doesn't have to be perfect. We will zoom in to position the trackers perfectly. Move the center of the tracker to the center of horizon in between two bars. Make both outer and inner tracker rectangles fall inside two green bars. Make some vertical room between inner and outer tracker rectangles to track the up and down movement of the horizon. However, leave no horizontal room. Click Options in the tracker panel. Select RGB channel because sometimes sky and ocean may have very similar luminance level. Check Enhance Before Matching for more accurate tracking. Also check Adjust Feature on Every Frame. This is important for time-lapse because it's long duration. The features may have changed significantly from start to finish. Click Play button to start automatic tracking. This should be a slow process. You may want to monitor how well tracking is doing its job. It seems to be doing a terrific job so far. A few minutes later, the tracker 1 is still doing very well, but tracker 2 is off. Some manual intervention is needed, unfortunately. Expand the tracker points. You'll find a list of keyframes in the timeline. Let's focus on tracker point 2 by zooming into it. We need to figure out the exact frame where the tracker has failed. I almost made a mistake. I should leave tracker 1 alone. I should expand tracker 2 now. Select all keyframes for tracker point 2 after the failure and delete. Let's create a new tracker from the point of failure. Click on pre-composition and click stabilize motion again. This will create a new tracker called tracker 2. In the options window, check the same items. Let's try to put the tracker 2 in the far right green bars that we haven't used before. Still doesn't look good because mountain's color is very similar to the ocean. Let's still use the same green bars, but we'll recompose this time. Put tracker 1 in the same position because it's not causing any trouble. Contrast level looks good between the cloud and ocean for tracker 2. Let's recompose and see how it works this time. Zoom in even further to monitor more closely. The tracking has finished and both trackers did a great job. Click apply for both tracker 1 and tracker 2. Make sure to choose both X and Y dimensions. After this step, many keyframes will be created under the transform effect for pre-composition. You can play the sequence to see how well the stabilization worked. It looks quite good to me. Collapse the motion trackers, but keep the transform effect open. You are going to link the original untouched sequence to this pre-composition layer, expand the transform effect under layer 2, which is the original time-lapse sequence. Click on the pickwick icon for anchor point and drag it to the anchor point for layer 1, the pre-composition layer. Do the same thing for position and rotation properties. These actions will let original sequence inherit the stabilization properties of the pre-composition layer. Click solo checkbox on layer 2. This will hide all other layers except for the original time-lapse sequence. We have successfully stabilized the hard sequence to stabilize. The only task left is to export. Open File menu and find Export and click on Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. For the best quality, we are going to export in JPEG format. Export is over, we will deflicker it with TLDF. Drag the whole folder into TLDF. It will start generating previews. When this step is over, it will play the sequence in real time. Check the flicker checkbox and click on preview. For more serious flickering problems, you may need to do noise reduction or blend. But for this sequence, there is no such need. The last step is to click on render and generate images and video. That's the end of this tutorial. I hope this is helpful. Let's end this video with some sunrise and sunset time-lapse on cruise ships.